And now, ladies and gentlemen, with us we have Professor Sayyid Irfan Habib, yes, the man himself, who is known as the encyclopedia of Shaheed Bhagat Singh in HSRA. So let's see what we can get out of him. It is such a pleasure having him here. A very good evening, sir. So, sir, first things first, how are you so closely associated with Ranbir Singh?
My association with Ranbir Singh is Shubhra Singh. Because my association with Bhagat Singh goes back to late 1970s, which means close to 40 years. And so anything or anybody associated with Bhagat Singh, including Ranbir Singh,
right,
is close to me.
Correct.
Is somebody to be venerated.
So were you present there yourself? You were with the army. Were you? How do you know so much about it, sir?
No. I can't be there because it's a very old
Absolutely.
Story. So my problem is when I finished my university post graduation, etc., and I was looking for something to research upon, something to take forward my own academic career.
Right.
At that time, I came across some writings on Bhagat Singh, which were laced with lots of intellectual inputs from
right.
the man,
right.
from Bhagat Singh. And those inputs were actually not very detailed because there was not so much available about him in
right.
1970s. So whatever was there was put in those few things which I read, which inspired me to take that project further.
Wow.
So I took it up as a PhD project, and then I finished my PhD on that.
And that's how we
Yeah, but the association ended for a while. In 1981-82, formal association, because then I got into, there was a shift in my interests, so I got into history of science.
Okay.
And the next 28 years I spent researching, writing books, articles, speaking about history of science. In 2007, people who knew that I have worked on Bhagat Singh in such detail with archival data, etc., and on ideology, because nobody has worked on ideology. And 100 years of Bhagat Singh were being celebrated in 2007. Then friends of mine in Delhi University here and there, they said, why don't you take a sabbatical from History of Science and do your book, which I did. I spent 6 months, revised the whole thing. And that book came out, which is called To Make the Deaf Hear. And that is the first book. Till today, there is no other book actually, which deals with the ideology of the man. So that association continues even now.
Yeah, that's true, Mr. Anand, when he spoke about writing the, doing a little bit of work on Bhagat Singh and Ranbir Singh and that. The first thing that was told to him by Dr. Shashi Tharoor also and General Guha also was that you are the man, and that if he comes to you, then probably we have an encyclopedia open to that knowledge. Right. So I have a question which is very intrinsic here. What does freedom mean to this nation today?
Freedom, I don't know whether that question can be raised in the context of people like Bhagat Singh's life, because freedom today, because their idea of freedom was absolutely different. And I'm saying this because today's freedom, of course we are free, the British are not there, the white are not there, we are not colonized anymore, we have an independent government. That's all in place, so there's no doubt about that. But Bhagat Singh in his writings, if you look at what he wrote, he very clearly pointed out that we don't want a government after the British go, a government which is not bothered about the people who are on the margins, who don't really, the government which doesn't care to fight for plurality, fight for secularism, interest of the downtrodden, a government which actually will be a government by 98% people in terms of participation and not just 2%
right.
rich.
Right.
So I don't think we have that government today. So Bhagat Singh's idea of freedom is of course not there. And though we have freedom, we have governance, we have government, but the idea of freedom, the idea of India, is they cherished. It's not there.
Well, there were authors like you, because of whom we have read about the heroes like Bhagat Singh, Ranbir Singh and all these people. And we have some kind of, point where, center point where we can say, okay, this is the definition of patriotism, or this is the value system that we should have. They were our heroes. And we had heroes like you who wrote about that. Today, that is a big missing point that we have, you know. So what will happen 10 years down the line when they have no heroes to look up to? What does literature bring in there?
No, I don't think we will actually come across that sort of period, because there will be people who will continue to write.
Right.
And these heroes who have remained heroes till today will continue to be heroes later on. And people like us, somebody else will come and talk about something new. So that's not the... So I'm not very pessimistic on that count. You know, because people... nobody's indispensable, and everybody has to live for the time he or she is living in, and contribute whatever he or she can, and should not bother about what will happen in future, because future has its own challenges, and I'm optimistic about that.
Wow, absolutely brilliant. We have today a beautiful lecture that is going to be delivered by you. We will have loads of information coming from you, and we really, really hope, we look forward to many more stories from you, which anyways I'm going to, you know, catch hold of you later on after that also. So here, ladies and gentlemen, we have Professor Habib with us. Tonight is going to be a very interesting night, with us going and digging into our history, knowing a little more about the great hero Ranbir Singh, and that is going to be done by Professor Habib. Thank you so much, sir, and hopefully we will again connect.